Peer group, I just share with you is now how these nuclear groups are made. So first, understand that. So based on similarity in nucleus structure, based on similarity in the nuclear structure. Different elements are divided in some groups. Which are called as nuclear groups. Okay, so first one we are talking about is, you know, we'll talk about isotopes. Okay, so what are isotopes? So these are elements which have same mass number but different atomic number. So these are the elements. So you all can also note down, these are the elements with the same Z. Now what is Z? Z is the mass number with same Z but different what? A. So different A means different atomic number, but they have same mass number. These are called as isotopes. Second one is what? It's isobars. Please note down isobars. These are elements with same atomic number but different mass number. So these are elements with same atomic number but different mass number. Okay. All right, that is Z. These are called as isobars. Now let us take the third one, that is isotopes. Okay, so what are isotopes? Let us discuss that. Third one is isotopes. These are elements which have same number of neutrons. Okay, so these are elements which have same number of neutrons. A number of neutrons is what? It will be so here Z is basically the atomic number. That is number of protons. And what is A? A is the mass number. That is number of protons plus number of neutrons. So this will be number of neutrons will be A minus Z. Okay, it will be A minus Z. This is the third one. Then, so there was a small mistake, you can correct it. Right? So it is AXZ, where A is the mass number, that is the number of protons plus number of neutrons. And Z is the atomic number, that is equal to number of protons. Okay, so number of protons actually decides the atomic number. Okay, and then we have the fourth one. The fourth one is it is called as isodipers. Okay, with this, I'm just telling you this for information. Okay, this is basically more discussed in advanced topics, but I'm just telling you. So these are elements which have same difference in neutrons and protons. Okay, so these are elements which have same difference in number of neutrons and number of protons. What does that mean? Suppose you have X, A, 1, Z, 1, and you have Y, A, 2, Z, 2. So A1 minus A2, okay, number of protons, difference in the number of protons will be Z1 minus Z2. Okay, that will be Z1 minus Z2. This will be Z1 minus Z2. And the difference in the number of neutrons, the number of neutrons in the first one will be A1 minus Z1. The second one will be A2 minus Z2. So this is the difference of number of neutrons. And this is the difference of number of protons. So this will be same. This difference will be same. Okay. These are elements which have same difference in neutrons and protons. Okay. So please note down till this point. So yahan pe dekho. We'll talk about the radius, okay, or the size of a nucleus. So the next topic is size of a nucleus. Okay, so many experiments were conducted to find out, you know, size. So based on several experiments, it was found that all nuclei means it's plural of nucleus. Okay, it's plural of nucleus, nuclei. There are so many nucleuses, right? And stable nucleus, there are some stable nucleus, some unstable nucleus. We'll discuss that in the next point. So it was found that all nuclei are made up of a highly dense material. Nuclear matter. Okay. Density of interior of every nucleus is almost constant. So this was one more important point. And I'll prove you that. Okay. Density of nucleus. Density of every nucleus is almost constant. Whether you take uranium or whether you take hydrogen, anyone will find that the density of the nuclear matter is almost a constant. Okay? All right? Okay? So this, you can say that the volume, because volume of a nucleus is proportional to mass number of elements. It, because density is almost constant, so it will depend on the number of nucleons, right? Mass number of elements. elements of what? Elements of nucleus. Just like we have India, and those who stay in India are Indians. Similarly, we have nucleus, and the elements of nucleus are called nucleons. We are Indian, civilization nucleons. Okay, so all these nucleons, if there are, you know, more nucleons, the mass will be more. If there are less nucleons, the mass will be less. Okay, so this is the relation that was established, right? That the volume of a nucleus, if I say 4 by 3 pi r cube, volume of the nucleus was found to be directly proportional to the mass number of elements, right? This is x, a, and z. What is a? A is the mass number. That is the sum of the number of neutrons and protons. And this is atomic number. That is the number of protons. That is equal to the number of protons. So from here, the radius, if you take cube root on both the sides, the radius was proportional to a raised to 1 by 3. And you can say radius is equal to some constant into a by 3. Okay? And that constant value was found out experimentally. That was r naught a raised to 1 by 3. So this is the equation of the radius of a nucleus, of any nucleus, where it depends on what? It depends on the mass number a. It is directly. So this is called as, you know, this is the equation of Fermi radius. Basically, this is called as Fermi radius because the scientist Fermi, he derived this, he explained this, that's why. And this R naught is called a Fermi constant, okay? R naught care. R naught is called a Fermi constant. And the value of this is 1.2 into 10 raised to minus 15 meter. Okay, this is the value. So please note down till this point, all of you. Okay, very good. All of you have noted down. So if we talk about the density kya hota hai? Mass by volume. Okay. So agar ye nucleus hai, if this is a, you know, nucleus, aur iske andar protons hai, neutrons hai. So number of protons plus number of neutrons. Agar ye mila kar, let us say A is what? Mass number. तो इसका मास क्या होगा? इसका मास हो जाएगा a into atomic mass unit, ठीक है? वॉल्यूम क्या है? वॉल्यूम है 4 by 3 pi r cube, ठीक है? और r का वैल्यू क्या है? r का वैल्यू अभी देखा आपने, वो है r naught into a raised to 1 by 3 का cube. वो हो जाएगा a into u by 4 by 3 by r naught cube, or a raised to 1 by 3 raised to 3 हो जाएगा a. तो यहां से आप देख सकते हो कि density is constant. The density is independent of a. Density जो है, it is basically independent of the mass number, atomic mass number. So therefore it is constant for all the nucleus. So it is almost constant. Huh? Highly dense, and it is almost constant for all the nucleus. So there are, you know, some protons inside this nucleus, and there are some neutrons inside this nucleus. So the number of protons, what is this number of protons? What is this? This is number of neutrons. नंबर ऑफ प्रोटॉन प्लस नंबर ऑफ न्यूट्रॉन्स को हम क्या बोलते हैं? उसी को हम मास नंबर बोलते हैं ना? यस यस
यस सर.
तो फिर टोटल मास क्या होगा? टोटल मास होगा मास नंबर, यानी टोटल नंबर ऑफ न्यूक्लियॉन्स. ये क्या है? न्यूक्लियॉन्स है. टोटल नंबर ऑफ न्यूक्लियॉन्स इनटू मास, एवरेज मास ऑफ ईच न्यूक्लियॉन, दैट इज कॉल्ड एज एटॉमिक मास. दिस विल बी द टोटल मास. Okay, so just understand, A is the total number of nucleons. A can, A is the total number of nucleons. Okay, A is the total number of nucleons. And this is what? This is the mass of 1 newton. Mass of 1 newton. तो total mass क्या होगा? Total mass A into U होगा कि नहीं होगा? Yes or no?
Yes sir.
Volume क्या होगा? 4 by 3 pi r cube. और r r अभी हमने discuss किया था. R का formula होता है r naught into A raised to 1/3. तो मैंने उसको यहाँ लिख दिया r raised to cube. ये हो गया r नॉट क्यूब और a रेज टू 1/3 रेज टू क्यूब हो गया a. a और a कैंसिल हो गया तो हम देख सकते हैं कि जो डेंसिटी आ रहा है इट इज इंडिपेंडेंट ऑफ a, इज इंडिपेंडेंट ऑफ मास नंबर, मतलब डज नॉट डिपेंड ऑन द न्यूक्लियस, इट डज नॉट डिपेंड ऑन द एलिमेंट, इट इज ऑलमोस्ट कांस्टेंट फॉर ऑल द न्यूक्लियस और ऑल द एलिमेंट. डू यू अंडरस्टैंड दिस नाउ?